I mean, there seems to be a whole different set of rules for Palestinian terrorists than anything else. For years, Americans were allowed to support the Irish Republican Army, the Contras. The government supported the Contras. It just seems to be the Middle East where suddenly there are lines drawn that you can't cross and rules made that don't pertain to anybody else. If one of the things that I noticed that when we were looking at the executive order that was signed stating what organizations, I didn't see any organizations on there that weren't Middle Eastern that you couldn't support. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe there was one or two. I don't remember a single one that wasn't Middle Eastern. Everything is geared towards the Middle East. You know, you want to support the Contras? There's no problem. You want to support the, you know, Republican arm, there's no problem. One of the problems that we had with the jurors also was supporting Elisan, which was a charity, which not only was the PLO, did it have PLO approval, but the state of Israel didn't seem to have any problem with them. That they would say that he supported Elisan, and by supporting Elisan, he was supporting terrorism. But I thought, it's ridiculous, you can't go by that. I can send money to Elisan. They could send money to Elisan. Anybody in the courtroom could send money to Elisan. But yet, if Sami Al-Arian sent money to Elisan, suddenly he's guilty of a crime. There was a double standard. He's a very principled man. He won't. I don't think he will plead guilty to anything he's not guilty of. I can't believe that, considering what evidence they have, and the government knows they have no evidence, you know, half of the counts have just been knocked out, and the other half, we had two people out of 10 that wanted to find him guilty, and they didn't have any reasons. They couldn't even give us the reason. The evidence isn't there. I don't think they would be able to get 12 people in one jury box unless they went to the most conservative Republican. I mean, they would have to hold his trial with the Republican Senate in order to find 12. I just don't think they're going to. They don't have the evidence. I don't think they can find 12 people that would find him guilty. Not on nothing. Even if the next jury finds him innocent on all the counts that we couldn't come to a conclusion on, he will not walk free in this country again.
Why not?
He's a scapegoat. They need to send someone back. They need to convict somebody, and if they don't, they'll at least send him away. Well, people at one of my jobs didn't talk to me for a while. They just kind of basically said, "What did you do?" And a few of them were of the attitude that, you know, the next time a plane hits a building, you have blood on your hands. But I think with each one that had talked to me, I had basically, all I had to do was ask them, "Well, if you know so much about the case, just tell me, of all the evidence they gave us, what do you think was the most damning piece of evidence against him?" And eventually they would just, I don't know. I don't know that anything about the case. And it's like, well, if you don't know about the case, how can you make that kind of a decision? And they kind of realize that, you know, unless you're in there, unless you know it, unless you've been following it, you can't make a decision on it. You really can't. And I think that helped a lot, because for the longest time, people at work, there were several people at work that didn't talk to me. Or when I came back from the jury, they were like, I'm not surprised. I knew you would do it. But they kind of realize that you can't. You have to see it all, and you have to be there. I mean, you can't even really hear and see all the evidence. You have to see everything. You have to see the faces of the people. You have to hear the inflections in their voices. That all has a part in it. And if you know, I will never play armchair juror with anybody when I hear about them on television. In my opinion, from now on, if a jury finds someone innocent, in my opinion, I'll just assume, no matter what I thought, no matter what I saw on television, if the jury found him innocent, I'm much more inclined to say they're innocent.